वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव रेड अबाउट कार्टिलेजेस, मसल्स. नाउ वी विल रीड अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ मसल्स. वी हैव रेड इट दैट देर आर मोर देन 600 मसल्स इन आवर बॉडी एंड मसल्स आर अटैच्ड टू बोन्स बाय स्ट्रॉन्ग फाइबर्स कॉल्ड टेंडन्स. नाउ there are three types of muscles in our body. First two types are, first is voluntary muscles. Voluntary muscles means you can control them. So these muscles are under our control. These muscles are present between our arms, legs, hands, feet, neck and shoulders. So all these muscles which are present here, we can control these, right? So voluntary muscles are also called skeletal muscles, right? Now next are involuntary muscles. These muscles are not under our control. They are involuntary. Involuntary means you cannot control them. They work on their own. Involuntary muscles are also called smooth muscles. Right? Voluntary muscles are known as skeletal muscles. Involuntary muscles are also known as smooth muscles. Now they control our breathing, flow of blood, movement of food in the alimentary canal. That means all through the alimentary canal. When food is moving through your digestive system, they control this movement, etc. And also other movements. Now involuntary muscles are under the control of brain and spinal cord. So they are directly in the control of brain and spinal cord. Next are cardiac muscles. Cardiac muscles in the heart, that means muscles in the heart are known as cardiac muscle. Cardiac means the heart region. They are involuntary in action. That means you cannot control your heartbeat. Right? So they are involuntary in action. The muscles of the heart work all the time throughout our lifetime. Now there is a fact file here. Sartorius is the longest muscles found in human body. Now how muscles work? Muscles have the ability to contract and relax. When we were reading the introduction of muscles, I told you that when you move your arm or when you move any of your body part, one muscles contract and one muscle relaxes. The muscle which relaxes because just to make the movement easier, right? I'll explain you this further. Look, when a muscle contracts, it shortens and thickens. When muscle contracts, it becomes shorter and becomes thicker also, right? And when we stretch, it becomes thinner. As you stretch a rubber band, have you stretched the rubber band ever? When you stretch the rubber band, it becomes thinner comparatively, right? But when you leave it and it becomes closer, it contracts, it becomes little bit thick. So when the muscle contract, it shortens and thickens, same as the rubber band. When a muscle relaxes, it turns to its original size. The contraction and relaxation of muscle help in producing movement by pulling the bones. This line you need to understand, because this line is showing you how muscles work. These movements help in walking, bending, jumping, etc. The muscles work in pairs. For example, when we bend our arms like here, one muscle contracts here. The muscle which is coming closer to each other is contracting, become thicker and it shortens in size. And the muscle which is relaxing, it becomes thinner and will increase in size. Right? Now, let's see keeping the bones and muscles healthy. How can we keep our bones and muscles healthy? To keep our bones strong, we should take food rich in calcium like banana and milk. Always sit straight and walk erect to keep the backbone healthy. You should not bend your backbone when you are sitting and when you are walking, because the actual shape is when you are keeping this, your backbone erect. It keeps your backbone healthy. Now last one is, we should exercise regularly. Playing outdoor games is also good for bones and muscles. Nowadays outdoor activities are not very often, but you can play or you can exercise indoor only to keep your muscles and bone in a healthy way. Next is, some activities are given here. Drink milk every day because it is rich in calcium and vitamin D, vitamin C. It's a complete food, so will keep your bones and muscles healthy. You should always walk, sit in a correct position. Thirdly, you have to exercise daily. That's all in this chapter class. Thank you.